Questions?
Not to get too much into the closed door stuff, but he was talking about accountability. How have you seen it change, you know, over the course of this year, even as you figure out this staff more and more?
Well, like Colorado week, it was okay. You know, the list, or I would say Akron, Colorado week was, the list was okay. And then you saw a change where it just went downhill. A lot of people getting on the list. And then right at Northwestern that week, that's when it came out of halt. Like, we had, I think, one person on the list, and now it's just not many people on the list. Or if it's people, it's probably one or two. So, and that's how you, if you look at our team, Colorado, great game, and then you see down, and then we come back up, start Northwestern, and that's how the list, how it correlates with the list. So it's just crazy to see Coach talked about accountability and how it correlates to the field, and it just is crazy to see that and see how we play those games and see how it actually works side by side.
So when you say, you guys are saying things have been changed in the last few weeks,
yeah,
that's the stuff
So Northwestern, I'm saying it changed during Northwestern. Everyone's starting to be, you know, accountable for the stuff they need to be accountable for. Going to class, weightlifting, treatment, all that. They're doing that. And then you see Northwestern, we played a great game, you know, lost that. Minnesota, you know, this game is all working together. So, you know, being a disciplined team, you have to be on and off the field.
Is there any level of concern with you guys based off of Kakun Cook? I mean, they were able to put a couple big plays up on you, about 5.5 yards of play against the starters. Mm-hmm. Going to Ohio State, is there any level of concern?
No. I would say even with myself, I was, you know, it was a good performance. But I think assignment-wise, or even like for a lot of the players, maybe the motivation to, you know, be disciplined at every single snap, like it's your last, like you're playing an opponent that if you do mess up, it's going 60. So I think that's what we was missing that game, and that's why those plays happen. So I think that if you would be crazy if you think Ohio State, if you mess up on a play, won't put 60, go 60 yards for a touchdown. So it's going to be different in focus when we talk about how we focus for this team.
Well, how would you describe Ohio State's offense the last two seasons? Just the challenge that they present, seeing that you've seen the challenge they present.
Oh, yeah, a lot of motions, a lot of four strong looks, four verticals. They like to stretch the field, RPOs, put in isolating their best player on your player, saying, okay, my player could beat your player. Finding ways to put linebackers and binds. Ever since I played them, that's the biggest thing they want to do. Even the curl flat player, you know, do I take the wheel? Do I come off on Dobson or something? And play that flat? And do I play high or low? Those players could do stuff with a lot of space. So that's stuff they like to do. Of course, they were more, you know, they have quarterback run games, but, you know, it's tapered off now since the quarterback they have at the helm.
Hey, with Ohio State coming off a loss and then now having a bye week, I mean, are you guys expecting to walk into kind of a hornet's nest knowing what just the pressure and stress has been out there the last 2 weeks?
Urban Meyer's a great coach. Everyone knows that. I used to watch his Florida teams growing up. So I know they would be prepared in the first quarter to play their best football of the season. And how you handle that is you have to be, you know, your alignment, assignments, your execution have to withstand the fire they're going to bring during that first quarter. And if you could do that, then, you know, Purdue's going to seep back in their minds. You know, the doubt is going to seep back in their minds. So that first quarter is big for us. We have to have an excellent first quarter, in my opinion. And that's going to set up the whole game. So it's all on the first quarter, I think, because in the bye week, they've been, you know, the coach has been cranking them. They've been doing Oklahoma drills, all that stuff. And, you know, they're going to come out playing with passion, with fire. and they're going to try to play their best game. And if we could stop them, if we could play with them in the first quarter, that doubt's going to see back in, and you're going to see that it's going to be a competitive game.
Anything else for Mo? All right.
Thank you.